you just kind of rub this lock and then.
Yeah, yeah, rub it. Yeah, open, yeah, rub that lock. So the other day I was watching a video by Atozi, as you do, and there was one thing that kind of just got to me. I thought some of this arcade stuff was common sense, that these hack videos are not real. I mean, I'm sure that there's one or two out there, but for the most part, these are not legitimate. And as an arcade technician, I wanted to break them down, but first I want to show you the clip that made me just... told me I had to make this video.
Push this button three times, 1, 2, 3, and then this, 1, 2, 3, and then the claw will open up, and you can get any prize you want. That's how to hack the claw machine.
Yeah, okay, if that's legit and not fake, she just taught a bunch of kids how to steal from claw machines.
No, there's no legitimateness to it. Like, I don't blame him, I mean, it's not like he's a technician or anything, but it still hurts me that he thinks there's a possibility that can be real. So I want to go back and show you why. First off, if you look here in this, like, still image, you can see these are two different claw machines. First off, this one here on the left is actually a game called Ticket Time by Smart Industries. The one on the right, I have no idea what it is, but they are not the same machine. They are not going to work in the same way. You can even see that they have different locks on them. Then they're claiming that you can press the button multiple times in order to get the door, like in a certain combination, to get the door to unlock. As you'll see later in this video, those locks aren't electronic. We have keys for a reason. You unlock them. We don't have to sit there and type in a passcode to open the door. We have keys.
And you can get any prize you want. That's how to hack the claw machine.
Now, here's another thing that I don't care for much in this video. So, first off, there are two different machines, there are two different prizes, but the Ticket Time in particular. Now, it's a little hard to see, so I could be wrong on this one, but most Ticket Time machines, there are some older ones that are different, have what's called an RFID system, where there's actually an RFID tag on every single one of those tickets, and you actually don't get them. If you've been to an arcade that has these, you've probably seen it yourself as well. The tickets pass over an RFID sensor, which it detects to give you your tickets directly onto your card, if it's on a play card arcade. So opening up this door to take the tickets out defeats the entire purpose. If you walk up to the counter with these tickets, they're going to know that you got into the machine somehow, not by pressing the button in a certain order, and they're not going to accept them. They don't even have a way to add them, unless they have certain barcodes, to the system. And it looks like on this ticket ring here in the back, right there on the inside, you see that little light gray? That looks just like an RFID tag. So this looks like, again, I could be wrong, one of the more commonly sold versions of this that use the RFID system. So for the purpose of proving these arcade hacks wrong, I have committed a mortal sin and downloaded TikTok. To be fair, I didn't download it to my phone, and I signed up with an alt account email because I don't want this associated with me one way or another. I am 25 years old. I'm not trying to appeal to the youth like everybody else over the age of 25 on TikTok trying to act like they're still a teenager. If you're still on there over the age of 25, whatever. I don't personally understand it. But I downloaded it so we can look at these arcade hacks because they are prevalent on here. And we're gonna debunk some of these and show you guys why these don't work.
You wanna come to the claw machine, you're gonna wanna move the joystick up two times, down two times, left, right, left, right, left, and then you wanna hold the drop button for at least 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so that's at least 5 seconds. And then what you're gonna do now is put your coins in like you're playing. So put your coins in. Put your coins in. And then what you wanna do is just go for anything you want. I want this little pineapple right here, so we're gonna go for that. And then once you line it up, what you want to do now, this is the most important part. You want to hold this drop button the entire time. So ready? Just keep pulling it, keep pulling it, keep pulling the drop button, keep pulling it, keep pulling it, keep pulling it. And there we go, guys. I just got two of them.
I don't know this exact game, but it looks like just a standard claw machine. And just like with the last one, there's no special combination of buttons and joystick movements that's going to allow you to win a prize. If you went into the settings and messed with the game to make it win automatically, cool. More than likely, those prizes are not the highest value. And so the claw machine is just simply easy to win. So he could have done multiple takes of this if he wanted to, or more than likely, he actually works at this particular arcade or knows someone that does.
I'm gonna show you guys how to win the claw machine every single time. All you have to do is come to the joystick and spin it for a couple seconds, and then go up, 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 down, 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 left, right, up, down, and then press the yellow button 3 times. And then once you put that code in, the machine is now going into maintenance mode. So as soon as you put your money in, this is only for the workers to test the machine to make sure it's working properly. So now line up your prize, and then before you drop it, you have to hold the button the entire time. So I'm gonna hold the button the entire time, and it works every single time. Watch this, guys. Look at that. Every single time. I just won it again. That's crazy, guys.
No. I assure you, we have better ways of testing the claw machine than by putting in a secret code on the outside of the machine. Inside of a lot of claw machines, the older ones usually have to deal with dip switches, but a lot of the newer ones, like, you know, we have a literal programmer that we can go to test various different things. We have, you know, various buttons in the inside for testing different things, going into different menus, changing settings. On the older ones, it's a bit more of a pain. But there's no special code, and you can also see, once again, these are two different machines, not even made by the same company. I believe this one on the right is made by Coastal, if I'm correct. And the one on the left, again, if I'm correct, is another Spartan Industries crane. And because it looks just like, it's a version of the Giant. It's a different version of what I have to personally deal with, but it looks just like the Giant. I'm pretty sure it is the Giant. It even has one of the decals, it's still the same. Two different companies. These machines are made years apart from each other. And there's no special code.
Yo, you guys, I'm gonna show you the coolest Keymaster hack that works every single time. You know why it works? Because the vendor uses this to see if the machine is working properly and in order, okay?
So my No, we don't, but you know what it is. No, we don't.
What you have to do, okay? So come over here. You have to move the joystick 2 times to the left, okay? 1, 2, and then go.
Okay, at least I'm not the only one that has to deal with cracked joysticks on Keymaster.
Right 2 times, 1, 2, and then hold on to this button for 2 seconds. This is the most important part, okay? 1, 2. Now, the machine is in maintenance mode right now. Like I said, the vendor uses this to test out the machine, but it only...
As much as I feel like I really would not like this guy in person, I approve of his shirt.
It works for the bottom row, okay? So look at this. You can pick whatever you want, but you have to scan your card first, of course.
It was a great manga.
Yeah, should we go for the Smarties?
Sure.
The Smarties are pretty cool. Look at this, guys. And once again, if this works, you have to like the video, okay? Here we go. Like that. Works every single time, guys. Look at that. Look at that. Smarties. A little container of Smarties. I'm gonna have so many Smarties.
Not much else to say on this. Again, there's no secret code.
Another arcade hack that...
Oh, it's this guy again. Okay.
Find this balloon machine. It works on this, but you need to have a laser.
Okay. Oh, okay. Everyone, so, in a way, this is the thing. This would probably work. I'm not going to say that it won't. It's also really underhanded. It can probably get you thrown out of arcade, more than likely. Especially because when that balloon pops, it is loud. And then it screams, as long as they have their volume up, to let you know that, you know, you won the jackpot. So they would hear it going off more than once if you kept sitting over there with the light doing that, and probably start to wonder what's going on. On top of that, it's hard to say that it's theft, because you're just getting tickets, but it's really borderline. Let's see if it works. I'm sure it will, because he's recording it and posting it online.
We're gonna scan our card, we're gonna play it really quick, let's see, right? There, but what we're gonna do, we're gonna see if it pops right. Here we go, like this.
Okay, so, again, you can see that the pumps weren't moving anymore, so it definitely popped by that laser, I would assume. But, again, it's just very underhanded, not a good thing to do if you want to keep going back to the arcade.
Magnet hack! I'm gonna use this magnet to move the iPhone into the prize chute from the claw machine. Oh my gosh, and that's how you win a free iPhone from the claw.
Okay, so a couple things. Yeah, that probably works, but this claw machine is full of plush, and I've seen on so many of these, I have looked through a few of these before, they always take a claw machine that's full of plush or another item and just throw, like, Apple AirPods in there, or they throw iPhones in there, and it Most arcades aren't going to have a random phone in there with all of their stuffed animals. That's not going to happen in most cases. It really feels like they just throw those in there, and likely with either another magnet or a large piece of metal, because your iPhone, especially in the kind of packaging that they put those in, that little weak of a magnet, not really going to do much. They had to have put something else inside of that box. Now, I have heard of other people using larger magnets to do more dubious things that we won't be going into here, because it can cause serious destruction of property. It can really hurt these machines. And for somebody like me who has never had to deal with it before, I really don't want somebody to come in my arcade and do that.
Here's a common thing that I see people do all the time. I'm gonna go like this in rapid fire.
Yeah, fair enough.
I win the jackpot, but as you can see, I'm missing like 3/4 of them. The demo screen, it actually shows you what to do. See how I'm doing buckets of four? I like to get down eye level, and I like to get what's called a strike point right before the right edge of the bucket hits the first line of the H. You'll notice a timer.
So yeah, obviously this is not this isn't a hack. This is actually just a good tip on how to play. This is the kind of person that you should actually watch, as long as he doesn't do other kinds of hack videos, because it actually does give you a good way to play the game. You also see how he has his hand on there. He's only hitting with his fingers with his hand down low. A lot of people will keep their hand above it and slap it. I've learned on a lot of these games where it's about timing. You want to keep your hand on the button. You want to press it in, but keep your hand on it. So this is actually a good tip, not a hack.
Guys, check this out. The next time you find a claw machine, here's how you open it. The machine's locked right now. But what you want to do, you want to press this for 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then you want to come down here. You want to press these 3 times each. 1, 2, 3. And then this one 3 times. 1, 2, 3. And you want to come back up here. Check this out, guys. It opens up. Look at this.
No! Alright, so this is where we get to the part where I have to show you guys these locks. So, what you can see here in the video is he is pressing the lock. Again, there's no electricity running through these. If anything, what he's doing is making sure that it is locked. Also, pressing those, that is a mechanical operation. There is nothing electronic in the coin return button, although I don't have to deal with these often because my arcade doesn't use them. I have in the past. It's a mechanical operation. You are physically trying to get the coin to come back out if it gets stuck. Not electronic. Those aren't actually buttons. I mean, in a way they are, but you understand what I mean. So let's take a look at one of these locks right here. Now, there are various different styles. This one's a bit different than ones I have to use as far as the key itself goes. But all these claw machines with the sliding glass doors, for the most part, the smart industries are a bit different. They use this kind of lock. These two holes are where it screws into the frame of the door. And that's it. See how this is pushed out right now? That's what it was like at the end of the video. When you push it in, you don't even need the key to lock it. When you push it in, it causes almost like a shaft to come outside the back of that lock, which I don't know why I'm pointing at the screen, but it comes outside the back of the lock and it wedges the two doors together so they can't slide past each other. There's nothing electronic to it. It's not a button. By pressing on it like he was, if anything, he's making sure it is actually locked properly by pushing it in further. Then, all of a sudden, at the end of the video, it just unlocked. It's almost like he had somebody above him with a key, so while he's down there wasting time pressing the stupid coin return button, somebody else unlocked the lock for him.
It's quick arcade hack. If you guys ever find Crossy Road, here's how to open the machine for free tickets. So you're gonna take these buttons right here.
Open the machine. Again, another lock one. Okay, let's go.
Let go, and then come down here and look at this. You get free tickets. Like, the whole thing opens up, guys. But don't tell anybody about this. It's super secret, so...
Again, just the standard lock. Nothing electronic. Technically, actually, I am wrong. There is one electronic lock that I know of, but it's not one that would matter anyways. But that's just a ticket door. Those are normal. She has the keys to it. She works at this arcade or knows someone who does. Here's the biggest thing. To a lot of you guys, all of this is going to seem obvious to you. All of this is going to seem like, yeah, obviously, you know, this is all fake. But then you look at this. This person has 140,000 likes on this video, with 1,945 comments. Hopefully, some others are pointing out the fact that it's fake. But, okay, plot twist, employee is behind you, eyeing you. No, okay, I thought that was somebody calling her out. No, okay, also 1,400 likes. Don't tell anyone, guys, tell this whole TikTok. Yeah, fair enough. Like, oh, here's, it worked, I tried it. I did this, my brother went to jail. Clearly, there's a lot of kids on TikTok, so that's the majority of the people that are going to be watching this and consuming this content. But for anybody out there who didn't know this before, it's not real. The big premise for me when it comes to arcades, you're there for fun. My personal opinion on it, the prizes and stuff, what you get for your tickets, what you can win from claw machines, those are bonuses at the end. Those are just an extra for the money that you spent. That's the way that I view it. That's not how everybody views it, and that's fine. But when you go into an arcade and your whole goal is to min-max, like you're playing an MMO, and you're trying to get the absolute most for your tickets, I feel like it takes a lot of the fun out of it. And that's the whole point of arcades, is to be a fun experience. Now, if you find it fun to go in there and try to get as many tickets as possible, like I did when I was a little kid, then fine. But trying to, you know, steal from an arcade, or trying to do these fake hacks and then getting disappointed when they don't work, just ruins some of the experience. And that's part of my issue with these videos, is people are going to watch these and they're not going to have an arcade in their area, right? And so when they go on vacation or they go somewhere that does, and they finally get to try out their favorite arcade hacks, they're just going to get sad that they didn't work.
Yo, you guys, look at this. I came back to the arcade because they still have the $100 right here, man, which is...
Okay, what? Ooh, okay. I want to know what state this guy is in. Most states... That's a crime. That's gambling. So unless he's in, like, Vegas or something, you know, I know it's not a state, but if he's in, like, Vegas or somewhere that gambling is allowed, that is a crime! You can't go putting money in claw machines!
Insane, but I understand why, because the way it's flattened out, I feel like no one knows how to get it, but I do. You guys, like the video right now, hopefully we get this. If I get this, I'll share it with you guys, okay? I'm not even lying. Here we go. Come on! That's good.
Oh man, what a shocker. He won the money. Which, again, I don't think they would ordinarily have in this claw machine, seeing as they all have like Valentine's themed things in there. It'd be nice if they had like a plush animal or something for Valentine's as well. But putting cash in a Valentine's like themed crane for the holiday really doesn't seem fitting, even if this is in a county or area that lets you put cash in machines. Just doesn't seem right. Okay, right as I paused it. See that right there? It was already open. He's just now putting his hand on it. Inside of the big bass wheel, there are two, like, retaining locks. They're not actually, like, key locks, because you have to use a key to get inside anyways, that hold that plastic down. When you release the two retaining arms, I suppose, you can lift up that entire thing of plastic. Now, this is mostly done for the sake of changing out the wheel, possibly, which I've never had to do before, thankfully, but it's done for cleaning purposes, and especially for trying to calibrate the game, making sure that when their tickets hit the arrow, like, you know, the value hits the arrow, it actually pays out the correct amount, and yada yada. It's for the sake of calibration. So this is already unlocked for them. Now, I suppose there's a chance that there is, you know, an employee who opened it up and forgot about it, but it's very unlikely, because you don't go calibrating these things every day. For the most part with this game, unless it has an issue with, like, the brake or the motor going out, like, there's very little purpose in having to calibrate it constantly. And usually that would be done by a technician anyways, who I doubt would forget to lock that, especially for a long enough period of time for a customer to figure it out, and to leave it already cracked open that far. They would have at least closed it all of the way. So no, this person works here yet again. Oh man, he won.
Yo, you guys, I have an arcade hack that is a very big, big secret, guys. So if you ever find a change machine that looks like this with a big token logo and you have Monopoly money laying around, it works. So please don't share this video because it is very secret. So once again, try it at your own risk, okay? So put it inside, Nicole. Look at this, guys. It is freaking amazing, man. Look at this, guys. So right now, it's going to register right now. Give it a second. Give it a second. There you go. Look at that. That's freaking awesome. So once again, if you ever have Monopoly money laying around.
So let's point out a couple things here. First off, let's go back. So after this stupid long intro saying, please don't share this video, which is just trying to get people to share it. First off, they put in both Monopoly money things at once, right? So that's already slightly odd. But here's the big thing. So they put it in, then he immediately zooms in on this. And did you see the shadow? Did you see the shadow on the red? That was them putting in an actual bill immediately after in order to get the tokens. Every time you see someone like, oh, put this in a claw in a token machine, it'll work. You don't understand just how thorough those bill readers are. So let's take a look at this. Now, not every bill acceptor works the same. This is the way that I generally understand it. This little piece of paper right here that you're seeing in the manual, this is just an example version, you would actually need to mark it correctly for what kind of bills you need it to take. So if you wanted to take 5s, 20s, 100s, 1s, 10s, 50s, whatever, you would mark those, and then you would put it into the bill acceptor, and it will set it to, it would configure it to be able to accept those bills. So you can tell it, oh, I don't want it to take 5s, and it won't take 5s. It's pretty simple. You notice that there's no option on here for Monopoly money. It won't take it. These machines are very good at detecting money. It's not gonna take your Monopoly money. I'm sorry.
So here's how you win the spin and win game every single time you come through the arcade. It's actually really easy. All you do, press the button 4 times. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then pull this thing 3 times. 1, 2, and 3. Just like that, guys. It'll put the machine in maintenance mode. So now swipe the card, pull the lever. Watch this, guys. We're gonna go for the 1,000 right up top. And right about now. There we go, guys. That's insane.
So spin and win is a very simple game. Heck, the bottom cabinet of that thing is massive with almost nothing in it. It's just there to make the game taller. We used to use it for borderline storage of parts for a period of time. This game is very simple. That handle is the most complicated thing in that machine, which just has 2 switches to tell when it's at the home position and the pulled position. Again, no secret passcode. I know this machine very well. I broke my middle finger fixing the handle on this machine, or well, attempting to. I know this machine well. There's no special code. Also, screw the motor in the center of this machine. You can replace it. It'll go out in a week.
You guys, I'm gonna show you another arcade hack because you guys love them. Come here. Look at this. If you ever find a crossy road, it works only on this machine, and they have them in every arcade. So you come down to this button, guys. You click this 3 times, and then you're gonna click this once. Look at this. 1, 2, 3, and then you click this. Hold on to it, and then that's how you know the machine's going into maintenance. And the people who own this machine does this to do. Look at this. Come down here to open this up, guys.
Okay, so the same idea as the other person. I always wonder who originates these. This guy posts so many of them. I feel like he's the original creator of most of these hacks. And then everybody else is just trying to use his ideas to make it look more legitimate. Again, no, that's not going into maintenance mode. We have a lock. We have a key to get in that lock. Also, maintenance mode wouldn't imply being able to open the door. Opening the door is actually the first step to getting to the settings for this game. Again, with a key. Would never call a love. That's a big magnet. That was a big boy. Okay. So, I 100% believe that he did just get that with the magnet, and there is likely AirPods inside. As they do have some metal components, it might be able to pull them if the magnet is that big. We can see that because if we go back and watch that again, watch the arm on the claw. It pulls the arm on the claw. If that's what it was, it could have been the reflection of the AirPods falling. But if that is what it was, then that is a very strong magnet. Which means more than likely, you just destroyed the AirPods. Now, I, again, doubt that they're actually in there. They probably threw a piece of metal in there, they probably threw another magnet in there, something along those lines. But if they were actual AirPods in there, with a magnet powerful enough that it wasn't even near that claw, and it was separated by the glass, and it appeared to move, it's gonna destroy those. They're not going to work.
I'm gonna show you guys how to win gold fishing. So you swipe your card, you get your balls,
okay,
and then you have your smallest friend climb in.
Okay! No, that's fine.
Go closer, go closer.
Yeah, that's okay. Yeah. Yeah, and he still misses. So, don't do this. Please don't do this. Not only can you break something in the machine, because yes, some of these machines you can climb inside of. Not you, the employees. They have to be taught where you can stand and where you cannot, because some parts of the game are more sturdy than others. Some parts of it are really hollow with very little support. Not only can you break the machine, but even if you slip and fall in certain games like this, where everything is at an angle, you can break something. You can get seriously hurt. We've had a few employees get hurt from climbing inside these machines, just either not knowing what they're doing or knowing what they're doing, and just making a mistake or slipping. This is very dangerous for you, because you don't know the sturdy parts of this machine. You don't know exactly how it operates. And it's not good for the machine, which makes people like me see you and tell you, hey, stop. If you keep doing it, it doesn't usually go well. Don't climb in the machines. You're going to break something on yourself or on the machine. This guy posted this out for 117,000 people liked this. Is that what that says? I see a K at the end there. I see a K. Don't. All right, I believe we're going to leave it there, so... Again, if you go to an arcade, do it for fun. If you want to learn how to get better at some of these games because you like earning tickets, you like trying to get that number as high as you can, then look for the people that don't claim to be doing hacks and codes and ways to open doors. Like the guy showing you how to play Quick Drop, like that is actually good advice. Like stuff like that, if you want to learn how to do better in arcades. These hacks aren't real. And don't attempt them. If you want to prove that they're, if you want to prove to yourself that they are or are not real, feel free to try out the ones that are not destructive. Don't climb inside of the games. And just go to the arcade and have some fun. So if you guys liked this video and you want to see more of this, there's a few of these guys that actually have YouTube channels where they appear to do a lot more of these, a lot more in depth. And I would love to tear them apart. So if you want to see that, let me know. Leave the video a like, subscribe down below, and hopefully I'll see y'all next time. Goodbye.